In this video, we'll talk about big IP connection mirroring. One of the members of a traffic group is a floating virtual IP address. If you enable connection mirroring on the virtual server for that address, the active traffic group will mirror its connections to whichever device is designated as next active. If the next active device changes, the big IP system will immediately begin mirroring the connections to the next active device. This means that a traffic group only mirrors its connections to one device at any given moment. For connection mirroring to work, each device needs to have a non-floating self-IP address that another device will use to mirror its connections. In a typical DSC configuration, you'd use the non-floating self-IP that is currently assigned to VLAN HA. You should enable connection mirroring whenever failover would cause a user session to be lost or significantly disrupted. For example, long-term connections such as FTP and Telnet are good candidates for mirroring. For this type of traffic, if failover occurs, an entire session can be lost if the connections are not being mirrored to a peer device. But the mirroring of short-term connections such as HTTP and UDP is not recommended because these protocols allow for failure of individual requests without the loss of an entire session, and the mirroring of short-term connections can negatively impact system performance. There are some important things to remember about connection mirroring. Connection mirroring reduces latency and prevents dropped connections on failover. A device mirrors connections per traffic group instead of per device. Mirroring for a traffic flow occurs between two devices only, current and next active. Connection mirroring is more useful for long-lived versus short-lived connections. And the active traffic group mirrors connections to its next active device using a non-floating IP address on VLAN HA. This concludes our series on DSC configuration. Thank you for watching and have a great day.